Hello everyone, and thank you once again for choosing HostBooks. This video is all about eWay Bill Part B update, cancellation and rejection. So let's begin. Visit www.hostbooks.com. Go to the software section and select eWay Bill. Now click on the tab Let's Get Started with eWay Bill. Enter the login details. Your username first. Enter the password and then click on sign up. You may also watch our last video for step-by-step explanation. Now let's click on generate eWay bill. So this is the main dashboard. We have a panel on the left side that has options like eWay bill, items, clients, imports, miscellaneous. Then we have the input details and EWB generated. Now click on the plus sign to create an invoice. Select the transaction type sales, that is outward, the subtype supply, document type sales invoice, then enter the document number. Select the document date. Next is the bill from section. Enter the name of the sender or add new contact. Enter the name first. Then enter the GSTIN or simply type URP. Select the state from the drop-down menu. Then enter address 1. Enter the PIN code. Then you may enter the name of the city. And then click on save. Then we have the bill 2 section. Similarly, enter the name or add new contact. Here, enter the name of the customer or the receiving party. Then enter the GSTIN or simply type URP. Select the state from the drop-down menu. Then enter the address 1. Next, enter the PIN code. The name of the city and then click on save. Now let's move on to the item details. Enter the name of the item or add a new item. Enter the item description here. Say refrigerator. Then enter the item type goods or services. Enter the HSN or the SAC. Then select the tax rate, it's 28% in this case, and then enter the selling price, that is after discount. You may also select the unit and then click on save. Then enter the quantity of the item. Then we have the unit of measurement, that is units. So here we can see the value has been calculated automatically. Next we have the transport details or part B. So here we'll enter the approximate distance in kilometers and then we'll select the transportation date. Now click on save. So this is the eWay bill input form and here we have the details like transaction details or part A. Then we have the bill from section and the dispatch from section as well, the bill 2 section, item details and the transport details part B. Now let's click on generate eWay bill. Enter the government portal login details, the username first. Then enter the password. And once you log in with the government portal details, you need not log in again and again. So the eWay bill has been generated successfully with the eWay bill number and the date. Now click on go. So this is the eWay bill view and we can clearly see that the part B has not been updated. It's incomplete. So now let's go to the eWay bill section. Click on eWay bill generated. Now let's open the eWay bill you just generated. So now we will update the part B. Click on update transaction details. So here we have the transportation mode date, then vehicle type will be regular. Enter the transport document number. Then enter the vehicle number. Enter the place of change and the reason too. You can select the reason from the drop-down menu, say first time. Now we will enter the place of change. Select the state from the drop-down menu and click on update. So the vehicle details have been updated successfully. So you can see here, now this part is complete. You can also click on the print option to take a printout. So this is how the eWay bill looks like. We have all the details here, part A and part B. And for more details, you can click on view details. So here we have the details of all the sections. Again, you can click on the print option to take a printout. Now let's go back to the eWay bill section. Click on eWay bill generated. You can see the status here, it has been generated. And there are two more options, cancel and reject. You can reject the eWay bill in case it has been generated by the counterparty. So here we'll select the status for cancellation and enter the remarks if any, and then click on cancel. So the eWay bill has been cancelled successfully. We can see the status here. And we can also take a printout. So here the word cancelled has been mentioned. Now if we check the status of the eWay bill, so we can see here the word cancelled is written. And even here the word cancel has been mentioned. So this was all about the process of updating, cancelling or rejecting your eWay bill. And thank you so much for watching.